In the previous videos, we saw how we can use concepts from linear algebra to make our code more efficient. Here I want to show you another trick, namely broadcasting, that we can use to do computations with unequal tensor shapes to save us some typing work. So consider this example where we have a vector consisting of four values on the left-hand side and we have a number on the right-hand side. And we want to add this number to the vector. In math, this would not be possible. We can't just add a single number to a vector. However, tensor and array libraries have a concept called broadcasting where they create dimensions implicitly. So what will happen if we implement this in PyTorch is that PyTorch will infer that we actually want to add a vector consisting of 5.6 to this previous vector. So it will create these implicit dimensions that we use for the addition. And this concept is called broadcasting. So as a result, in PyTorch, when we add a number to a vector, the output will be a vector where the same number is added to each element in the input vector. So here at the bottom, you can see how that actually looks like in PyTorch, and you can see that this actually works. Similarly, we can add a vector to a matrix as shown here. So on the left-hand side, we have a 2×4 dimensional matrix, and on the right-hand side, we have a vector consisting of four values. Now, when we add this vector to this matrix in linear algebra, this would not be possible because that would be a dimension mismatch. However, PyTorch would implicitly generate this new dimension so that the dimensions between the left-hand side and the right-hand side match. And then we can add these two matrices together. And to show you that this actually works, here's a code example that you can try out. Yeah, and in practice, this broadcasting saves us a lot of work. So in this case, we can do certain things much more efficiently with less code. All right, now that we are familiar with tensors and basic concepts from linear algebra, we will actually take the code from the previous unit and implement it in PyTorch using these concepts. But before we do so, let's take a quick look at how we debug our code. Just in case you stumble upon little issues, you have an effective technique to find little bugs in your code and make your coding faster and smoother. Thank you.